What's good, famo? It's your boy Project Professor, aka the Hood Historian, back with another episode of Trap History. Today we're gonna be talking about Ed Sheeran's recent case and also look into the long history of stolen black music. As you may have heard, Ed Sheeran was recently cleared of infringing copyright in Marvin Gaye's Let's Get It On in a lawsuit which took place in Manhattan federal jury on Thursday. But Ed Sheeran is just the latest in a long line of artists who have been accused of stealing from black musicians. Let's take a look at some of the most infamous examples. In 1953, Big Mama Thornton recorded the original version of Hound Dog, a song written by Jerry Lieber and Mike Stoller. However, just a few years later, Elvis Presley covered the song and turned it into a massive hit, overshadowing Thornton's version. In 1970, George Harrison released My Sweet Lord, which was a huge hit. However, the song's melody was later found to be very similar to the Chiffons' 1963 hit He's So Fine, and Harrison was sued for copyright infringement. The case of Willie Dixon versus Led Zeppelin. Willie Dixon, a blues musician and songwriter, sued Led Zeppelin for copyright infringement over their song Whole Lotta Love, which he claimed was based on his own composition You Need Love. The case was settled out of court in 1985, with Dixon receiving a songwriting credit and a share of the royalties. Chuck Berry versus the Beach Boys. In 1963, the Beach Boys released their hit single Surfing USA, which was heavily inspired by Chuck Berry's Sweet Little 16. The Beach Boys failed to credit Berry for the song, leading to a legal battle that resulted in Berry receiving a writing credit and royalties for the song. Sam Cooke versus the Rolling Stones. Sam Cooke's 1964 hit song A Change Is Gonna Come was allegedly plagiarized by the Rolling Stones in their song The Last Time the same year. Cooke's estate sued the Rolling Stones for copyright infringement, resulting in a settlement and credit for Cooke. James Brown versus the Beastie Boys. In 1986, the Beastie Boys sampled James Brown's funky drummer in their hit song Hold It Now, Hit It. Brown sued the Beastie Boys for copyright infringement, resulting in a settlement and credit for Brown. But this history of theft goes back even further than these examples. In the 1800s, white performers would often steal the work of black composers and musicians without giving them proper credit. Stephen Foster, a famous songwriter, is known to have borrowed heavily from black spirituals. However, in recent years, there has been a growing awareness of the issue of cultural appropriation and the exploitation of black music by white musicians. This has led to increased scrutiny of cases where white musicians have been accused of stealing black music.
Oh,